Hello everyone, my name is Manisha and you're watching our YouTube channel Punishka Tutorials. Today we will learn about addition of two rational numbers. Before adding any two given rational numbers, you have to first check whether the denominators are same or not and are they positive. First of all, if the denominator is negative, any of the denominator is negative or both the denominators are negative, in that case your first step will be to make it positive. You can do this by multiplying it with -1. So our first step will be check whether the denominator is negative. If it is negative, then make it positive by multiplying the rational number by -1. Now when we get the same denominator, in that case, add only the numerator part and retain the denominator part. So our required rational number will be sum of all the numerators upon the common denominator. Now, if the denominators are different, okay, and the denominators do not have any common factor among them, that means the HCF of all denominator is equal to 1. In that case, you will add the two rational numbers AB upon CD in this way. Write the first rational number on the left hand side and the second rational number on the right hand side in this way. Make X symbol and multiply accordingly. Multiply A and D, that means you will multiply the numerator of the first rational number with the denominator of the second rational number. Okay, AD plus the denominator of the first rational number with the numerator of the second rational number BC. AD plus BC, this will be the numerator part, upon BD. BD will be the denominator. So AB plus C upon D is equal to AD plus BC upon BD. When we add two rational numbers with different denominator and their HCF, that means the highest common factor, is equal to 1, in that case you will add like this AD plus BC upon BD. Okay, if the highest common factor is not equal to 1, that means if HCF is not equal to 1, in that case you will find LCM of the denominators, you will make the denominators common and you will add all the numerators. So required rational number would be sum of all the numerators upon the common denominator. Let us take some examples. Suppose you want to add 5 upon 7 and 9 upon 7. You can see that both the denominators are same, so we will add only the numerator part. 5 plus 9 upon 7, which is equal to 14 upon 7. Now bring this rational number in its standard form and you'll get the value as 2. Add minus 3 upon 5 and minus 4 upon 5. If you see, the numerator here is negative. We are considering negative rational numbers for addition here. Numerator can be negative, but denominator is not supposed to be negative on performing operations like addition or subtraction. We will add the numerator part, minus 3 plus minus 4 upon the common denominator 5. We will get the value as minus 7 upon 5. So minus 7 upon 5 is our required rational number. Suppose you want to add 6 upon minus 5 and 3 upon 5. If you see, our first rational number has denominator as negative. It's a negative rational number. We will first make the denominator positive. We will multiply the given rational number 6 upon minus 5 with minus 1. We will get it as minus 6 upon 5. So now we have to add minus 6 upon 5 plus minus 3 upon 5. Now the denominators are same. We can add minus 6 plus minus 3, which is equal to minus 6 plus 3, which is equal to minus 3 upon 5. Our next example, what if the denominators are different? Here the denominators are 5 and 10. They have common factor, that means HCF is not equal to 1. So we will find the LCM. LCM of the two denominators is 10. And we will make the first rational number with denominator 10. We will multiply with 2 to get the denominator as 10. Now we got the rational number 26 upon 10. So 13 upon 5 can be written as 26 upon 10. Now we will add 13 upon 5 plus 17 upon 10 is equal to 26 upon 10 plus 17 upon 10. Here we got the denominator common, that is 10. Now we will add only the numerator part. 26 plus 17 upon 10, which is equal to 43 upon 10. So if the denominators are different and their HCF is not equal to 1, that means they have a common denominator, common factor. In that case, you will find LCM and you will make all the denominators common. And then you will add the numerator part. Let's take one more example, minus 5 upon 7 and 6 upon minus 9. In this case, our second rational number is negative. Same method we will follow. We will first make the denominator positive. We will multiply 6 upon minus 9 with minus 1 to get the denominator positive. Minus 6 upon 9 is our required rational, the new rational number with positive denominator. Now we will add minus 7 upon 7. And minus 6 upon 9. Here denominators are different, so we will use this method. Write first rational number like this, minus 5 upon 7. Second rational number is minus 6 upon 9. Write minus 6 upon 9 like this and multiply first. Minus 5 into 9 plus 7 into minus 6 upon 7 into 9. AD plus BC upon BD. Okay, you can remember it with the symbol or alphabet X, or you can also remember this by the name butterfly method, which is equal to minus 45 minus 42 upon 63, which is equal to minus 87 upon 63. This is the required rational number. Sum of the two given rational number is minus 87 upon 63. If you have any doubt in this video or any of the sum, please comment it in the comment section and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.